Joe's in the hospital.
Joe?
No, Joe.
Joe.
Joe Green.
Oh, no kid.
Hello, boss.
Hey, Joe. What happened? I'm looking for you.
What is it, Chief?
Joe Green is in the hospital.
Yeah, I was just telling you how that read it.
Yeah, too bad. Too bad it wasn't fatal. It could have been with the right kind of workman. Sit down.
I've got to, I tell you. I've got the telephone.
Mr. Green, you can't phone anyone. Doctor's orders.
I must, I tell you. Just once.
Mr. Green, you're a very sick man.
I promise to obey all your orders from now on. If you'll just let me talk to Johnny Cave. I must, I tell you. It's urgent.
Very well. Just this one call, but no more. Plug in the telephone for Mr. Green.
Department of Weights and Measures. Oh, yes, Mr. Green. No, Mr. Green. I'm positive he isn't in because there was a call from Mr. Cave just a minute ago from the city prosecutor. Yes, Mr. Green. As soon as he comes in, I'll tell him you want him. Yes, I will. And take care of yourself. And don't worry. Hello? Have you located Mr. Cave? Well, please keep trying. I'll call back later. Where is Mr. Cave? 212, second floor.
Thank you.
Dr. Richards, please. First hall to your right, third door. Information desk. Yes, Dr. Richards, she's on her way up now.
Pardon me, I'd like to see Joel Green, please.
Sorry, but Mr. Green is not permitted to have visitors.
Well, will you please tell him Johnny Cave called?
Mr. Cave? Oh, I've been trying everywhere, Mr. Cave. Please go right up. Mr. Green is in room 612.
612, thank you.
Sounds like just another order. But I'm telling you, Johnny, I understand. I was crossing the car tracks. Suddenly, the automobile ahead of me stopped. I jammed on the brakes. The machine ahead started away just as the streetcar hit. When I came to, I recalled a face. One of the men in the car ahead looked back just before the crash.
You recognize him?
I think he's one of the gang.
Cavanaugh's?
Yeah. Marty Cavanaugh's.
I've never met that mug, but I want to make it my business to before long.
You're no longer a professional. Remember, you're in the Department of Weights and Measures.
I'd like to take his measure.
I'll give you the chance. But the department wants evidence, not problems.
They tell me I'll be here for weeks.
I'm going to make you chief deputy.
Me?
Yeah, in my place. I know I can depend on you, John.
Thanks, Mr. Green. Glad you think so.
Yeah, well, remember now, keep your head on your shoulders and your fists in your pockets.
Yeah, I'll be stuck.
You'll have to be. This Cavanaugh's plenty dangerous.
Yeah, I'll take all the bite out of him. And our troubles will be over, huh?
Cavanaugh's just a preliminary. The main bout's yet to come. Someone higher up.
Oh.
I wish I knew.
No visitor's time is up, Mr. Green.
I'll just leave it.
Now. Now remember, Johnny. Don't let that fist drift against anybody's chin.
Oh, don't worry. It won't. You should be able to play that next time I see you.
You were, sir.
Got lunch and date, babe.
When and with whom?
Today, with the guy you're going to marry. Remember?
Vaguely. Name, please. Oh, Johnny Cave, of course. A great guy. He told me so himself.
You wouldn't doubt him, would you? Same place, 12:30. And don't be late.
What? Me late? Well, I like that, of all the nerves. What are you talking about? I'm usually the one that has to stand around waiting 20 minutes for you to show up.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. But you heard me. Don't be late.
Now, on your head, you
I'm just pinch-hitting for Joel Green while he's in the hospital. Now, you know, without my mentioning any names, who put him there. And why? Because he wouldn't take orders from anybody except people who trusted him. He knew what it meant to cheat the housewife. Of course, it doesn't sound like much, chiseling just a few ounces of meat on the pound or a few potatoes out of the sack. But understand this. 40% of the American income is spent on food. And if people are cheated out of only 5%, in 1 year, that adds up to more than the war debt. Now, it's a big job. A big racket we're fighting. People on the other side of the fence have a great deal at stake. And they're going to make it very tough for them. So if there are any of you who are a little bit afraid to tackle it, now's the time to move. Thanks. That makes it unanimous. Now, here's a neat little gadget. And one of the latest. Here we have a 2 pound weight. Put on the scale. It still weighs 2 pounds. Watch the hand. But very tough on the housewife. And you'd be surprised. The name of some of the stores is still proper boots to advantage. Very delicate point. Practically every time you make a pinch, you're going to be offered a bribe. Now, some poor deputies have taken bribes. That's your answer.
I was late. But do you know where I was? I was around to all the newspapers to see if they knew that you were the new chief deputy.
Mm-hmm. Where are you from?
Well, I was born on the Great Basket Island off the southwest coast of Ireland. But I live most of my boyhood in a little bit of a village outside of Foxburn, County of Mayo.
Mm-hmm. Not the type of the kosher markets. I think I better take you myself. If you don't mind, I'll just go any well wishes. Yeah. This is it. I've got a lot of complaints about this one.
Oh, well, I wish I think I'd buy some strawberries. How much are they?
25 cents.
Mm-hmm. Are they fresh?
Fresh, and every berry is big for a size.
Mm-hmm. Take a box.
Yes.
You know, there's a saying in Ireland that it's all right to pick the berries, but you must never, never cut down the vines, because under the vines live all the good fairies. And if you cut down the vines, you do away with their power to do good for you, huh?
That's very interesting. But there are no strawberries in Ireland.
Well, now I could swear I saw some of the county fairs.
I think I'll buy 5 pounds of sugar.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. 5 pounds of sugar, please. How much is that?
8 cents.
Yeah, you are even money. Well, Aloysius, what do you want for supper?
Oh, I don't know. Something that would stick to your ribs. I've got an appetite for corned beef.
And I've got a reason for chicken.
How about a nice stewing chicken? About 6 pounds.
Okay.
There you are. 6 pounds right on the head. Wrap it up.
We see it.
Lovely.
And just later. Get home.
Sorry, what's the idea? You said... Oh, Miss Greedy, Miss Greedy!
Very cute. Balls and disorders make no noise at all.
Not bad, not bad.
What is it? What is it?
I poisoned.
Well, how do you suppose those got there?
Your guess is as good as mine. Let me have that sugar. Four and a quarter pounds. I pay for
them. I can't understand, Pat.
We want to do our best to help you. Let's do it.
You haven't missed any bets, have you?
about buying that Burke back for $50, huh?
Oh, you wasted money. He spoiled by the time he got out of jail. Hold on to that other wishes, that's evidence.
It'll not leave my hands.
Give me that check. I want it. No, 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 give it. You hit me. Give me that. Oh, you will with it.
Time in your life, Ned. Now hold on to that. And another move out of you, and I'll pin your ears back.
Yes, sir. Fill it up. Five. Yes, sir.
Did I never tell you about the giant causeway? There were big giants in Ireland, so big, they stood on the top of mountains and they threw hills at each other. Mm-hmm. And then there were the leprechauns, little people, no bigger than your thumb, and you could see them walking around. Mm-hmm.
Say, my grandmother used to tell me about Lucifer the devil, who had one big me and one little me. You ever see that?
Oh, man, is that terrible.
Thought so.
That'll be 93.
This is a company car. I'll need a receipt.
Okay, just a minute.
It's our last job before lunch. I've got a date with my girl.
Take her to the Echo Cafeteria. It's a new
Oh, you've not a chance. You go to the Ritz today. This is a celebration. An event.
Oh, I see.
How much did you have in there?
Not a drop. The car's tank is about inside. One to run on, and the other to know your 5 gallons.
Oh.
Just as I thought, a little over 4 gallons. Well, thanks. You were warned about this violation last summer. Now you draw a summons.
Oh, wait a minute, fellas, wait a minute. Listen. Can I give you the fine and save me the trouble of going downtown? Oh, come on, what about $20?
I'll save what you need it for the fine. Put a tag on that, put it in the car. Huh?
Oh,
there.
Why, you!
Did you break your hand?
Oh, no. Thomas.
We got a check for $1,000 for the midnight mission. Mailed it right away.
Thanks again, Mr. Kelly.
Well, not at all. My pleasure. Goodbye, Mr. Marvin.
Oh, Mr. Kelly, would it be all right if I attended this after lunch? I have a date with my boyfriend.
Of course.
Oh.
Run along. Check and wait.
Thank you, sir. Johnny Cave, dear, you're 5 minutes late, honey.
Oh, you're very lucky. I've kept others waiting for days.
Well, any time you want to go back to those others. Perfectly all right with me.
My best friend gets hit by a streetcar, winds up in the hospital, civil war in Spain, and earthquakes in Japan, and now you wear that hat.
What's the matter with this hat?
It embarrasses me.
Embarrasses you?
Yeah. I had it on.
I'll wear it if I like it and I like it. Where shall we eat?
We'll go to the Ritz.
We're not going to the Ritz. We're going someplace that fits our purse.
Sweetheart, this is a celebration.
We're not going to the Ritz.
A fine way to talk to the chief deputy.
We're not going to the Ritz.
For the first time since I've known you, you're going to do as I say. We're going to the Ritz. Cagney. Deputy Chief of Weights and Measures. Pushing a tray.
You skipping that spinach?
I certainly am.
Another portion, please.
Fine way to talk to the Chief Deputy. Say, would you care for some nice spinach, my Chief Deputy?
What are you mumbling about? Pot roast.
Joe Green's in the hospital.
No.
Automobile accident.
Oh, that's too bad. Are you being serious?
Serious enough to keep him there for several weeks.
Oh, I'll have to send him something. Well, that puts you in charge.
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, I just want to get her out of the bedroom.
Jello. Two.
No jello, apple pie.
No apple pie. Jello.
Lunch at the Ritz. It's so much more social to eat. That's very social.
I put your money in the bank yesterday.
Yeah?
Uh-huh. I'm surprised. I picked out the winning ring. Just a plain gold pen, but lovely.
I've got my eye on this one, Miss Margaret. You set us back on
the... Yes, just the bedroom set and all the kitchen furnishings. No, we can't afford it, Johnny. I'll wait.
Now, since you're making your own decisions, why are you going to make the leap?
I've been thinking about that, too. What do you say? 3 weeks from Saturday.
3 weeks from Saturday? That's two more paydays. We'll be in swell shape.
Aren't you glad I made you save, Johnny? Now we have enough to furnish a cozy little apartment. On the installment plan, but it's just...
Installment plan? It's a racket.
With you, everything. Everybody's a burglar, everybody's a crook. You don't believe in philanthropy. You don't believe in public spiritedness. You don't even believe in men like Mr. Canning.
All I know about Mr. Canning is he's your hopeless.
Oh, Johnny, you're hopeless. What would you do if I said Joel Green was a dishonest man?
You say you were cockeyed. Mm-hmm. He's honest and the day is long.
Well, that's just the way I feel about Mr. Canning. And I should know. I've been with him many years. I was with the firm years before he made me his private secretary.
All right.
I love you, Jim. Oh, Mr. Cagney.
Yes, ma'am.
I wonder if I can have a little information from my private file.
Oh, why, certainly.
Are you married?
Well, yes.
Any children? Oh, how silly.
Yes. Do you want my number?
I've got your number.
You've got my...
Oh, Mr. Haley, I wonder if by any chance you happen to be going my way.
Well, which way are you going?
The only thing is, I live at 191st Street.
There's a very funny thing, though. I'm going within two blocks of it.
Oh, fine. Will you hold my number, Mr. Haley?
Yeah.
Haley. Haley, that's such a lovely name. It has a certain ring to it.
Did I ever tell you the history of the Haley?
No.
You know, Charlemagne, the emperor of the whole West, he was the first Haley. And one of the kings of Ireland, he was a Haley. Do you know that I am the first son of the first son of the first son for 600 years straight down to...
Haley Selassie.
Yes.
Hey, it's 10 after 6 if we don't pay overtime.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
On time.
I'm always on time, except when...
Good night, Aloysius.
Don't be working too hard, John. I always say a fellow isn't happy unless he enjoys his work. And the only way to enjoy your work is to do very little of it. Except, of course, in a case where you have something to do which you can't put off. In which case, you can always quit your job because you say...
Good night, Aloysius. Good night, Hazel.
Good night.
Take good care of yourself.
Don't worry about her. She knows all the answers.
Sure, I do. If you'll stop talking long enough for me to use them.
You're Johnny Cagney, weren't you?
Yeah.
I'm Marty Cavanaugh.
district leader of the 7th. I figured we ought to meet. We've got a lot of things in common.
Well, would you come in, Mr. Cavanaugh?
Just plain Marty to you, Johnny.
What can I do for you?
Not a thing, kid. Not a thing. I came over here to do something for you. How about coming into my club? Our organization can use young fellows like you.
No, thanks. I don't think the boss likes us to belong to political clubs.
Well, you've got your own future to look out for. Why, you might get to be a district leader like me.
I couldn't dress the part.
We'll fix it so you can afford to dress this way.
That's very nice.
Cave, a friend of mine spoke to me about you. He thinks very highly of your ability.
Fine.
He asked me very particularly to do something for you. How about deputy leader at $200 a month? And that's just a start, you understand? Now listen, you can just a minute. What's on your mind? Well, I happen to have a summons here that you gave Evie at the Paradise Market.
And you want me to forget it?
That's the idea. You do want something, we'll cut you a nice little slice of cake.
No, thanks. I don't want some.
What are you being so noble about? Going around with a chip on your shoulder. Listen, this stuff is all unimportant. A grocer or a butcher charges a woman 3 or 4 cents more than she's supposed to pay. So what? She never misses it. Look, I'll show you what I mean. You got 3 pennies? Just to prove that they don't mean a thing. See? You've lost 3 pennies. You don't miss them, do you?
Well, that all depends. I'll show you what I mean. See? You lost a hat. You don't miss it, do you?
Now listen, Johnny. We can do things for you or to you.
You mean you'll do to me what you did to Joe Green?
Now take it easy. Now listen. I'll turn the heat on for anybody who threatens my men or tries to slip money on my desk block. It's a one-way street, Cavanaugh. And if you start up, you're going to meet me coming down.
Let him have it, boys. He wouldn't listen for reason.
Where do you think you're going?
They're going your way.
No, he ain't. He's going our way.
That's right.
What are we waiting for? Come on, let's get it over with.
We just sit here and think. Try thinking, Red.
Are you trying to commit suicide?
You don't mind if I stretch, do you?
Fred, that ain't for us. That's for some hookwits breaking the law.
11 even. Come on, we roll.
I don't like that penny on you.
Put this little mop on.
For what?
Put it on.
Hey,
told you guys to do all this?
A little boy, kid. The boy's 5 foot of spring. Get in there.
Say, I'm telling you, I was framed. They poured liquor all over my clothes, hit me over the head, left me lying in the gutter.
You said that 14 times.
I'll say it 14 more.
Ah, we're getting nowhere fast. Bring in the complainant.
Why, hello, Johnny. What are you doing here?
That's your man.
Is this the fellow supposed to have stuck me up?
Yeah.
Well, this ain't the guy.
Friend of mine.
How are you, Johnny?
What?
Sure, Johnny Cage, Chief Deputy Weights and Measures.
What about the red hair and that coat?
Well, you can't arrest a guy for having red hair. Besides, that isn't the coat. The one the stick-up wore was an entirely different color.
How about this gun?
Well, Cage got a permit, ain't you, Johnny?
You ought to quit wearing that coat, Johnny.
A coat like that is bound to get you in trouble. Shouldn't be a lesson to me.
This reminds me of the story of the guy who, right after the wedding, socked his bride in the jaw. Then he says to her, "That's for nothing. Now be careful."
Your head feel better?
Pop that.
Really?
If it's more good than opiates.
You know, Johnny, in a way, it's your own fault. That chip on the shoulder comes. Now, you can't go around stepping on people's toes and expecting them to like it. You're too aggressive. It's that Irish.
What's the matter with the Irish?
I didn't say anything was the matter with the Irish.
You did, too.
I didn't. There you go, scrapping at the first opportunity. There's no sense of trying to be nice to you. Let me tell you something, Johnny Cave. If you don't want to listen...
All right.
May I call your attention to this charming love scene?
Look, darling. I've got to be at the mayor's office in about 5 minutes. Pick out anything you like. But be sure to get me something I can put my feet on. Bye.
What have you got for feet?
A footstool.
Mr. Cagney.
Oh, Mr. Cagney. I'm sorry, but his honor has been unavoidably detained. Won't you ever see him?
Can't wait. There are too many important calls to make.
Oh, Mr. Cagney. His honor is very anxious to see you. Won't you please wait in here? His honor is on his way now to the new bridge. He made the dedication speech.
Who wrote it for him?
Oh, Mr. Cagney. Cave is waiting for you.
Oh, fine. Don't let anyone disturb me, Helen. Oh, Mr. Cave. I'm glad you came. I've good news for you. Mr. Cave, I want to congratulate you on your record. Since you've been with the Department of Weights and Measures, your name has become a synonym for honesty.
last year shows an increase of 53% in the number of arrests. I ascribe such a showing to your untiring efforts. It's superb.
Colossal.
Precisely. Now, we wish to reward you properly. We're appointing you to the Governor's Tax Commission as Special Investigator. The appointment carries a salary almost double your present one.
That's very nice, Your Honor, but you see, I...
Now, as a much older man, one who's devoted most of his life to the service of the Commonwealth, I advise you to accept. We have great need of a man of your caliber, Mr. Cave, in the Tax Commission. Great need. As has often been said, necessity is
the mother of suspension.
Levity, Mr. Cave? Fall and take them, I think.
Sorry, Your Honor. I'm very, very grateful for this opportunity, but I can't take it at this time.
I'm afraid this position can't wait.
What deals are trying to be subtle? I don't believe myself. Now, look. I'm staying in the department, and there's not going to be any fix. I know I'm treading a lot of toes in this organization, and I also know that the boys want me out of the way.
That's a bold statement, Mr. Cave. I'm sure you don't mean it.
I mean it. And you can tell Mr. Marty Cavanaugh, who instructed you to call me, that I said so.
Are you suggesting that Mr. Cavanaugh dictates the policy of this office?
What do you think?
Volcanic on the phone. Yeah? Arrogant, swell-headed troublemaker. Definitely dangerous. Must be stopped.
Never mind. We'll find a way.
How about 18 holes in the morning?
Right.
I say, the sudden notice of my removal from Skin is a great shock. It leaves me with a very helpless feeling after all my years of service.
I'm afraid you objected a bit too strenuously, Mrs. Ogilvie.
Mr. Cave, we were being cheated. And for a long time, the deliveries were always far short of what we were compelled to sign for.
That everything comes as far as pictures are concerned. And here's the list of everything that was to come out of the truck.
That's all, Joe. Yes, I'm the guy in line. I got it. Hey, what do you think? Keep your shirt on. As long as the
seems to be a bit of a difference, Mrs. Ogilvie, between the items receipted for and those delivered. At least 50%.
Of course, there always is.
I want you to sign this.
Not me, sir. Want to get my job?
The sign will give you a chance to think it over in a cage. That includes for you, too. Don't sign with an X. Hi, honey.
Johnny, what are you doing here?
Just dropped in to make a call.
Office hours? You know better than that.
Well, what can you do with a guy that's in love? I want to get a look at you.
What happened at the mayor's office?
Offered me a job.
Good one.
On the governor's staff, lots more dough.
Johnny, how wonderful.
Oh, I don't know.
Johnny Cave, you're not going to pass up an opportunity like that. Sounds like your real chance. Think what it means to you. What?
Goodbye, Annie.
Red Cave, you old palooka! I ain't put a lamp on you since we fought those 15 rounds in Jersey City.
Glad to see you, Pete. Hey, getting kind of soft, aren't you?
Oh, I've been taking it easy.
I'm going to take it even easier. You know, I saw my breweries and bootlegs still see some stock manipulators. They're going like theirs, running the stock up and down.
That dirty crooks.
What are you doing here? I come up to get a passport. I'm going to England. I'm going to play around with them dukes.
snivetsy dolls. You know, drink tea, chase foxes. Why do they chase foxes?
It's supposed to be sport.
And I'm going to skip. I don't want to be a sport. I'm going to be a gentleman. I got 3 million smacks of cash, man. 100 different names in 22 banks.
Well, what's Canning got to do with it? Sending it to his bootmaker?
Bootmaker?
Hmm.
Well, I went with boots. I ain't going waiting.
Oh, well, you came up to get a passport.
Yeah, Canning fixed it for me.
Nice.
Nice, but $5,000. He really ought to done it for nothing. Listen, Brad.
In the last 5 years, I've paid Canning his mom $1 million fixed money.
I ain't spoken. You understand? I want a protection. They gave it to me.
Say, well, then I didn't know that Canning took that kind of dope. Nobody will call him at it.
Nah, nobody's going to trip him up, Brad.
But you never tell me. There's always that unnoticed banana of you.
Not him, Brad. What are you doing up here?
Well, Canning's secretary's my girl. I like her.
Well, congratulations, you lucky stiff.
Oh, Janet, watch me a friend of mine. This is Pete Riley. Used to be in the leather business.
Yeah.
I used to get red samples. Pleased to meet you. Got the finest guy in shoes.
I think so.
See, I'm throwing a big party tonight at the Grillion. I got a whole floor there and a cage full of butlers. I want you both to come.
Oh, it's going
to
be a swell blowout.
But I'm going to fancy trimmers. I'm going to make a speech, too.
I wouldn't miss that. What do you say, Donald?
Thank you, Mr. Riley. We'll be there.
Great. 9:30. So long, you old palooka.
And skip your dinner. I got $1,000 worth of fancy grub coming. He made a speech on the radio once.
He spoke on the radio?
Yeah, he said, oh, my. It was a good fight. I'm glad I won. My second's only going to that.
Oh, I'm glad you're not prize fighting anymore. Listen, Johnny, about that job the mayor...
What do you mean something to me?
You know I'll do anything I can.
Well, if I prove to you that this boss of yours is not the shiny example of what you're supposed to be, will you do some snooping for me?
Johnny, how could you suggest such a...
What's wrong with...
Mr. Canning, this is Mr. Cave.
Mr. Cave, Department of Weights and Measures? Well, I'm delighted to meet you.
Thank you.
Will you come in?
Yes, thanks.
I don't want to hold you up, Mr. Canning, if you're going someplace.
Not at all. Glad to have a chat with you.
Sit down.
Thanks. His Honor, the mayor, we played golf yesterday. You sort of put him in the spot with the governor.
Oh, really?
Yes, indeed. He promised the old boy he could deliver just the man he wanted, and well, you turned him down cold.
Oh, I'm sorry if I upset any of his plans.
I believe you're making a big mistake. My long experience prompts me to offer my advice. Of course, you can take it and leave it as you see fit, but I do believe you should give this opportunity further consideration. It is an opportunity, Mr. Cade, believe me, and one that might open the door, so to speak, to a very bright future. What do you say?
You really think I ought to do it?
I do indeed. Let me give the story of your acceptance to the papers.
Let me give it to him.
Okay.
I want to congratulate you, Mr. Canning, on your kindness to charity. I heard about your latest gift. No thanks. Murphy, please. Murphy? Johnny Cave, your weights and measures. Say, I've got a paper story for your annual edition. Huh? Well, here's your headline. Abel Canning steals bread from mouth of city's orphans. Collects your supplies he never delivered. Send a compliment over to my office in about 20 minutes.
You wouldn't dare.
I gotta be going, Canning. I've got an appointment.
You go through with that, Cave, you'll wish you never were born.
I'll see you in jail, Brent Snatcher.
How dare you talk like that to me?
Wait till you hear the prosecuting attorney has to say to
me. Well, let's see here, Johnny.
Keep out of this, will you? I'm giving you the affidavits this afternoon. So long.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Kennedy.
Don't be sorry for me. It's the young man who'll suffer. If he gives his blackmailing scheme to the papers, I'll...
No.
I won't have to do a thing. Public opinion will force him out of office. He'd be lucky if he escapes a jail sentence.
You don't know Mr. Canning like I do. He's a fine man. Well, he's done everything for me. Put me through business college, gave me this job. Well, he's been like a father to me. No, Johnny, you're mistaken. Well, don't do anything I can't forgive you for.
You won't have to forgive me for anything, baby. I know what I'm doing. I've got...
the story?
You bet. Print it.
Thanks, Mr. Cave.
Thanks, Johnny. It's a charge to have.
City Prosecutor's Office speaking. Ask Johnny Cave to send down all the papers on the Canning case right away.
Just a moment, please. Mr. Cave, the Prosecutor's Office wants the evidence on the Canning case. Shall I take the papers down?
Then I'll bring them down myself in a couple minutes.
Mr. Cave says he'll bring them down himself in about 2 minutes.
Thank you. Anybody ask me on the back of my head?
Things over, Mr. Canning. I made a bad deal. $500 ain't enough for them papers. They're worth a lot more to me. Oh, I should say about $5,000.
$5,000? You weren't taking any chances. Not with me behind you. But you're taking chances now. Yeah? Oh, get a load of this. I'm not going to have one of them sudden accidents. Because up Callaway will tell the city prosecutor what the papers are.
$5,000, or I'll peddle them papers someplace else.
Find anything yet, Pat? I gave all the description I could. What if it all happened so quickly? I'm not completely dizzy.
Still dizzy.
Well, you do whatever you think best. As far as I'm concerned, you're the police department. Well, you keep digging through those pictures, and I'll be down there.
It's worse than that, Johnny.
What's this?
Your bank book. All your savings are there. But your department, not anymore.
Oh, no, darling, you don't mean...
I mean, we're through. Finished. Mr. Peace, listen, you've got to let me down in the papers. I've written to enough. It's no use, Johnny. You've hurt me. I beg you not to. But you wouldn't listen. You never listen. You're arrogant. You're stubborn. We could never be happy together. I love you, but I'm going to get over it. And you... Well, don't. I don't ever want to see you again.
about this guy?
No.
Well, here's a big baby. There's the guy, Pat. You're like a boxcar.
Joe Burton, alias Belden, alias Bilkowitz, ex-wrestler, 4 convictions.
That may be the answer to an Omen's prayer. Get this guy. Hello, Lieutenant.
Oh, I gotta get Charlie and Joe, a couple of pigeons, a car. Take all of 20 minutes. Charlie, listen. You haven't got a thing on me, Hammond, and you know it. You got a lot of crust pinching me and breaking the law. I could have you busted for this.
But quite a pull, eh, Joe?
Yeah, no way. Let me use that phone and I'll get sprung out of this trap in 5 minutes.
Plenty of time. Telephone girls will be out all night. You don't remember strong-arming this fellow this afternoon and stealing his papers.
I never monkey with kids.
Take it easy, Johnny. He'll talk or we'll keep him here till Christmas. Hmm. 6 tickets for Marty Cavanaugh's political jamboree in the moonlight. Marty, a friend of yours?
Yeah, in a way. What about it?
Nothing. Mike, take him downstairs a while. He's tired. He needs a little rest.
You can't do this to me, Hammond. I tell you, I've got an important date.
Oh? Mike, on the way down, tell Mr. Burton the story of the lifer that wanted to know what time it was. Go on. Well, you see how much singing that canary did.
Yeah, so I noticed. But anyway, we've got to the carbonators. I'd like to get a quick frisk.
I was coming to that. Well, this is the only key here. Look at that. Mother must have given him that to tease on.
Well, thanks, Pat.
Take it easy now, Johnny. I'll be sure to examine the drain pipes under the sink.
Can't fool me. I'll even look under his pillow.
Good luck.
There aren't going to be any ifs or buts about it. I want Joe Burton released at once.
Well, I'll see what I can do about it.
You'll see about nothing. You'll do it.
Okay. Marty, get me Captain Hanlon on the phone.
I haven't got anything on him anyway.
Then let Burton go. Orders from the boss.
Oh, that's all right. I didn't want Burton. I want those papers.
Think Burton still had them?
Certainly, that's when they got him out of here.
That's right. I'd like to give that mug another working over for the way he bawled me out playing it. Said he hardly had time to get his map scraped and massaged. Going to that big blowout Pete Riley's given tonight.
Burton's going to Riley's party?
Says he has an invite.
So am I. I've just got time enough to get my bag bags on myself. I'm Burton again.
Look out, Johnny. Burton's tough. I found that out.
You should be dancing, not sitting here decorating the wall.
Thank you. I'm waiting for Mr. Parker. He'll be back in a minute. Won't you sit down?
Thank you. Say, what's this run around you giving my pal?
Mr. Riley, I'm not giving anyone a run around. Just sitting here minding my own business.
I get it. You want me to mind mine? But this is my party, and I want everybody to be happy, especially you and Johnny.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather not discuss it. Besides, I don't think you'd understand.
It's my guess that maybe you don't understand Johnny. Don't you read the papers? This guy's in a jam. See all that beef on the book?
It was in the heart of the jungle, with a hippopotamus on this side, a leopard on the other. At my heels was a tiger, and right in front of me was a roaring lion. Well, I was in a pretty bad way.
But what happened?
What happened? I was killed.
I'm surprised to see you.
When you gave me the invitation, Pete, I thought you meant it.
Sure I did. You're as welcome as the flowers in July. Come on, I'll stick around and introduce you to some of the models.
Oh, don't bother. I'll find my way around.
Okay, find yourself a spot to dance with. I'll see you later. If you want a drink, flag a butler.
All right. May I see you a minute?
Yeah, sure. That's my banker, honey. Go potty your nose, will you?
I'll be right back.
Oops. Am I going to hurt you?
No, that's all right. Wait till I see if my nurse is in.
Everything all right?
Yeah.
Nothing to offer.
No. Hello, Mr. Cagney.
Janet.
I'd like you to know Mr. Parker. This is my boss, Mr. Cagney.
Delighted, Mr. Parker. You're in very good company. I agree with you, sir.
Thank you. Wait a minute.
Say, what happened to that big mug with a bit of blonde fluff?
Don't mean that guy that's been marching up and down my heels all these times.
Yeah. Seen him?
Not lately.
You can't scare me, Cagney. It's $5,000 or no papers, and that's fine.
It's a hold up.
Yeah? What did you call that little trick you had me?
You don't think I'd carry $5,000 around in my pocket?
I'll take a check made out to cash for the key to my apartment. That'll make it a legitimate business. Not that it makes any difference to me. Hey, do you mind if I leave you here?
No, not
at all. Didn't find your way back to here?
No, I'll find him all right. I'll just take a ride and go find a little bit of money.
I'll see you then.
Let me go up first.
Look, and I'm sitting right there in the left room. I'm sitting right there in the left room. I beg your pardon.
What happened? I never did find out. Well, you threw a wide right. I led with a left in the stomach.
I led with a left, with a right.
I'll show you.
I led with a left, and you brought in a left, and I threw a right hand and missed. Get back. Will you give me some air? Get this guy some more, will you, please? Now, where's that water?
Shot of scotch. One for me, too.
That's right. You take care of it, Alex. Explain them how it happened. I'll see you later. Making comparisons here, sir. My father always said you've got to know something about the weeds to appreciate the rose.
Mm. Well, let's get out of the garden and pay some attention to me.
Oh, yes, sir. I was simply telling the girl to go. Excuse us.
Listen. You keep your eye on Burton. Tell my husband I'm out of here. I'm going over to Burton's apartment. Tell him
that I'll explain it.
Excuse me.
What's your name?
I beg your pardon. You're a friend of Johnny Cave's, aren't you?
I'm proud of
him. Aren't you the girl he's going to marry?
I hope so.
Well, if you're put a Johnny than mine, you might be elected.
Has he gone out?
No, he's gone out looking for a better trouble. He has a date with Mr. Cagney at Mr. Burton's apartment.
Which reminds me, I have a date with Mr. Burton.
Excuse me.
I've been robbed.
Let me out of here.
Johnny wants Mr. Burton to wait for him, Mr. Bradley. It's very important.
Oh, yeah? Do you think you're big enough to kill me?
Oh, boys, are you staying right here? See, Mr. Burton doesn't leave the party. I want him to stay and enjoy himself.
All right, come on, folks. Step up. Let's have something. Dave, quick.
Hello, police headquarters. And let me speak to Mr. Hanlon, please. Oh, well, Captain Hanlon, then. Just say a friend of Johnny Cave's.
Keep your eye on the door.
Chief Deputy, wouldn't it be just too bad if you were found here stiff and cold, shot while committing burglary?
You haven't got drive enough to use that rod on me, Cavanaugh.
Funny, I thought I had.
Take care of him.
Till after I get rid of these.
Party is at Riley's. Oh, Marty. And without a permit. Mike, I'm afraid we'll have to arrest Mr. Cavanaugh.
I'm afraid so.
Firebug in a high hat.
Everything all right, Johnny?
Yeah. Kind of toasted around the edges, but it's all here.
I'm afraid we'll have to arrest you for, what'll it be, Johnny?
Oh, attempted arson.
Well, that'll do for now.
You can't arrest me. Let me have that phone.
Oh, no, it wouldn't be fair to Mr. Burton. He'd have to pay for the call. I'll send a man to pick him up. I think we'll have a little get-together, and Pete Riley may send some sandwiches. Take good care of Mr. Canning, Mike. And don't bend him. Well, let's get going. Come on, Marty.
See you in a minute. Let me out of here.
Open that door, Johnny.
You're going to get what's coming to
you. You can't hit me. I'm under arrest.
Oh, no?
Come on, Johnny. Open this door. Open this door. You can't beat up my prisoner.
Johnny, you didn't use the money we'd saved.
Oh, of course not.
Yeah. See for yourself. It's all intact.
How did you get the ring?
Bought it, of course.
But how?
On the installment plan.
But what about...
I know. It's a racket.
Oh, but Johnny...
call your attention to this charming love scene.